We always have the country stations on back home, and a lot of the regional stations played just country music, which is great in Ireland, you know, which is a shame there isn't a lot more, kind of, it's great to see there are some stations emerging all the time, you know, with Chris Country and Radio 2 are huge supporters of country music, but I think there should be more, you know, and it's evident as well with festivals like this that there's a huge demand for it.
Yeah.
Growing up listening to him, going to his gigs, and then when I was 12 years old I started playing guitar, my mum taught me the first few chords, and then that's when I started writing songs, and I was like learning chords but writing at the same time, and all throughout my teens and that, and it was sort of the singer-songwriter route that is the path that I was following, and then I joined the Saturdays, and that was a huge departure from what I'd been setting out to do, but it was a great experience, and I loved every minute of it, but I am really happy to be back doing this again. Yeah.
Let me move along to you, Katy. Your country is pretty, goes right back into your early days of music.
Yeah, it really does. Yeah, I've been singing and listening to country music my entire life. I think I started when I was about 3, and my parents used to play me Patsy Cline and Jim Reeves, and that was just what we had on in the house growing up, and it just kind of took over.
It was kind of harder to find though then, as innocents, you know, at least now we have more places where we can all go to hear this.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I mean, I was living in the States at the time. Both my parents love vinyl, so we had a lot of that kind of stuff going on. But I'm really glad that there are festivals like this now that give us a chance to kind of showcase our music and get everyone who likes this genre together, because there aren't very many opportunities for that. So.
And the other thing is that, you know, I think now no one has to be scared about liking country music anymore. So, you know, we all know.
It's not a dirty word.
Yeah, that's right. There was a time, wasn't there, where I think a lot of people were always into it and didn't think anybody else was. And then suddenly this festival came along.
Yeah, I definitely got teased a lot in school whenever I'd say country and people just assumed that you were kind of doing Dolly Parton Western style stuff, and I love Dolly, don't get me wrong, but that kind of style of music was the very traditional stuff that people had ingrained in their mind, so when you said country they went right back.
Mm-hmm.
And then like there's several decades that were missing from their kind of education in that genre, so it's pretty exciting that you can actually hear more of the modern stuff.
Give us a song. What are you going to play for us?
We're going to play a song called See You Later, and this is going to be off my new EP, which is currently available for pre-order on Pledge, and we showcased it yesterday, the first time on Town Square stage, so I'm excited to play it for you guys too. And it's one of those songs that was a little bit of a slow burn. I think it took us over a year to write it, and this is Gab, by the way. It's going to be playing all the nice guitar stuff, and wrote the song with me, and we started writing, we had the title I'll Be Seeing Ya, and we thought that would be a good story, but I think we tried several different directions and then eventually kind of it fell into this, so it's pretty cool.
Crazy her.
Mr. Persistent, keep your distance, you must think I was born late.